company that owns this radio station has been bought by a Chinese conglomerate as of last week. Our format should not be affected. However, we have to bring you this. We're going to tell you about the five shining virtues and the three treacheries. The five shining virtues are punctuality, respect for the upper class, respect for fellow workers, good hygiene, and flossing. The three treacheries are stealing from the upper class, stealing from churches, and that kind of spongy-type floor mop where the power strip just falls right off. An astronaut once rubbed a lamp, and after that, his every wish was granted. But your Council of Churches reminds you, you can't solve every problem by rubbing something. Work hard, drive safely, and every night come home to your family or halfway house and turn on your radio. We'll bring you a science fiction tale from long ago. Let's say it was 1893, and a couple of Frenchmen and a robot monkey are going to fly to the moon for the first time. In one of these hot air balloons they had, of course it had to be a mighty big one to make the trip over 5,000 feet wide and pumped full of air. They hooked it to the earth, and the whole earth floated away, sailed up to the moon, landed on it, and squashed it. 75 years later, Neil Armstrong gets there, and all the mountains, trees, and landscape have been squashed flat. So he thinks it's just a dead rock. It took 100 years after that before mining companies on the moon dug down deep enough to find the truth. The moon was once a tourist village consisting of a miniature Earth with rides, food stands, and an even littler moon orbiting around that. Stay tuned for the firecracker warning. Nowadays are so insane from the crime war, there's no telling what they'll do when they catch you violating the ordinances. Crazy serial killer phony cops love to fool delinquents with so-called firecrackers that are really dynamite sticks. They light the fuse and toss it back and forth to you. These are 2-pound sticks of dynamite that blow up the both of you. Crime, as well as law enforcement, don't pay. I'm Mr. Mark. I'm just telling you. In the background, Torch Song. That's a new group featuring William Orbit. Blue Night, the name of the track. And the name of the CD, Toward the Unknown Region. Torch Song. Before that, Maximum Radiation Level by a group called Man or Astro Man. From Deluxe Men in Space. York before that, Hyper Ballad. That was T's radio edit. Of course, I'm a radio guy. Top of the set there, Love and Rockets with Trip and Glide from their new one, The Glittering Darkness. And that, comma, is what you heard. When shopping in a shopping mall, remember mall courtesy. Clerks may slap customers only under certain conditions. Customers should understand that they are rude, obnoxious cattle crowding the aisle in numberless millions. And clerks should realize that they are untrained, unskilled, slow-assed zombies who can't find the bathroom doorknob. Mutual understanding is the secret in retail relations. And if you're out shopping and shots ring out, don't panic. Nowadays, a violent crime happens so often, the cops melt down the spent shells to make police cars. Try to grab the gunman, put your finger in the barrel, and reason with him. If pesky police come along, send them on their way and say you'll handle it. The cop will nod approval and head for the cookie counter while you fight crime and save the economy. Remember, Mall cops aren't real cops. Mall cops are high school kids hired on part-time to commit crimes and make work for real cops. Mall cops scare away the dumber breed of shoplifter and reduce parking lot break-ins by removing the stuff themselves. You can grab their hats off and fling them like frisbees over the railing. Mall cops will dive headlong after. Those hats mean so much to them. Best way to test mall security is to snatch a few products yourself. See if you get caught. Amateur store detectives and sloppy security should pick you off, but no soap, they've missed you. Try dragging out some of the potted plants and statuary. The mall fountain goes next, then roll up the carpeting and carry out the ceiling tiles. You stole the mall and stuck it in your car trunk. Now don't forget the gift your loved ones truly want is the gift of yourself, Nookie. The Mr. Mark Show is brought to you by a rift in the fabric of space-time. Jump in your radio and come out again on the planet of Lobstermen, which turns out to be the dark side of the Earth. I'm just telling you. I'm Mr. Mark. Howdy, slackers. Your parents are concerned for you, afraid you might be molested at the Happy Hugs barbed wire day camp. Only one way to test those camp counselors. You guessed it. Mom and Dad dress up in diapers as the world's largest babies. Of course, Dad has to shave his back. Then they hide behind the boathouse there, and when a counselor comes near, like the trapdoor spider, they spring out. The counselor dies of fright. Now Mom and Dad are on the run. Wanted for felony murder charges, if caught, they'll be tried as babies and still get the death penalty anyway. Fugitive giant babies could be your mom or dad. Pick up the phone and turn them in. If you conceal your deviant parent, you could be charged as an accomplice. If they're found guilty, you'll get a reward. Think about it. This message from your deviant uncle, glad to deflect attention towards somebody else. If you think you've seen grown men and women wearing diapers, but you aren't sure, could be time to call your skilled hypnotist. If you can't afford a real one, get a party hypnotist. They're cheaper and funnier. Party hypnotists tell you to watch the watch. If you do go under, they'll take your clothes, and what do you know? You wake up naked, handcuffed to a police station. Some gag. When holiday time rolls around, remember to play a cruel and traumatic practical joke on a friend or enemy. Just ask your insane war veteran or psychopath convict. The Mr. Mark Show is brought to you by way of a free trade agreement with a parallel world. If you don't believe me, it proves I'm lying or possibly telling the truth. If you don't believe me, stay tuned. Most of you know the Mr. Mark Show comes on every Wednesday night at 8. Here comes the live ID for you. WMUH Allentown. Tile your bathroom with beautiful, inexpensive Mexican tiles from a desert village. Oops, those tiles contain hidden drugs, which are Cotylenol. To relieve headache and flu symptoms, just lick the wall. In come the cops to drag you away to jail. You were duped by drug lords, sentenced to life in the gas chamber. This warning word from the vice police, who are hoping for a nice, quiet evening without any trouble from you. Here comes another warning word about your teeth. Dentists agree to disagree that your mouth is a hellhole of poison and decay. Get yourself to a drugstore and brush, floss, guzzle down anti-plaque mouthwash and calcium pills. Too late. Your teeth spring from your gums and fall into your cups. Prevent this catastrophe through hygiene. Tooth decay is caused by a germ called dental caries. Vaccines could prevent you from ever getting cavities, but that would starve your dentist and his college-age children. Better instead to scrub your snow-white teeth every day and have expensive examinations and bridge work, followed by a root canal, and finally, euthanasia. If your car dies, we'll tell you what to do. Safety first out on the dark, cold, hostile, and violent expressway. Do the smart thing. Your highway safety guy spells out for you. First, fix your car. If you can't fix your car, then roll up the window, lock the doors, and hide on the floor of your automobile under a blanket till the car thieves come. The car thieves bust in, take your auto for a wild ride over an embankment and into the Little Lehigh Ocean. You're still on the floor of your car and too proud to complain. The seawater pours in, naturally. But thank gosh, it's okay. You've already died of fright. Ergo, car care is the thin blue thread that separates you from posterity. Have your mechanic check the brakes, shocks, battery, and tires. Rotate the seats and apply zebra striping to the ashtray. Now you can drive with confidence and steer boldly across the ice. If you do slam into a police car, do like you ought to should and sign a confession. Do hard time in a holding cell. I'm a disc jockey spelling out the hard truth to you, and I gotta tell you what's coming up next. Oh, boy. It looks grim for a while. Well, it makes no difference. You hang in there all the same. I'm Mr. Mark, Mark. Hello to civilians, veterans, members of the group Trapdoor who might be tuning in. We have a word for you about your car. Your car is like the human body. Keep your car in good health. Clean out the insides using your service station mechanic. Use biosafe, clean-running engine fuel, such as lead-free cobalt or butane from your lighter. But the most important thing to remember about car maintenance is safety behind the wheel. Don't drink and drive, and to drive the point home is this story about a drunken parachute skydiver. In military war games, he triggers a real-life nuclear disaster. By falling down the chimney of a cigarette factory, he turns into a radioactive, glow-in-the-dark lizard man who feeds on radon and comes to your home or office building to tear off the roof and look inside. What a trick to play on a guy. That lizard man doesn't eat radon at all. What a lot of panic over nothing. The lizard man feeds on human flesh. He only wrecked your house for a gag. You can get back at the cigarette factory lizard man by giving up smoking. Quit this bad habit through cold turkey. No artificial anything. If you can do it, the station will give you a WMUH t-shirt for $10. If you can't do it, the shirts are $10. The Mr. Mark Show today is based upon the central theme of the family, the core of unity, represented by the hearth, symbol of the home, broken in your case. Who could blame your long-suffering family for leaving you after what you did? Remember that your car is like the human body. So keep your car in good health by adding antifreeze to the ashtray in summertime. When it spills out as you go over those rough roads, the green drip, drip, drip will remind you to turn your radio on. Tuned to 91.7 FM, you'll escape into a dream world of illusions. Drip, drip, drip. In the background, Higher Intelligence Agency from their album Free Floater. Before that, Dead Can Dance from their new one, Spirit Chaser. And at the top of the set, League of Gentlemen from a new live release called Thrang Thrang Goes in Bulk. It's the first League of Gentlemen to be on compact disc that I know of. And all of that is new stuff. All of that is new stuff. So let's leave the new releases behind and go back to some old stuff for a while. Old stuff coming up. But first, before I do that, let me just say this. The Mr. Mark Show. Brought to you just like in a cloud layer. And as the trancing music fades up, it's just like a fog of frequencies. Boy, that's beautiful too. Mr. Marcho, I gotta go. You could have HIV, the AIDS virus, then go to Planned Parenthood on Thursday, December 5th for a $5 test. All services at Planned Parenthood are completely confidential. Call 1-800-230-PLAN for the Planned Parenthood nearest you. Thursday, December 5th, a $5 AIDS test. 1-800-230-PLAN. Okay, yes, in the background right now, Future Sound of London, from their new release, Dead Cities, the track We Have Explosive. Before that, Iggy Pop, Real Wild Child, an old track, but from a new release, which is a best of Iggy Pop release called Nude and Rude. And the track Real Wild Child, we thought was a good exemplary track for the Iggy people out there. Beatles, before that, an alternate version of Helter Skelter. Kind of bluesy from Anthology 3, you know, the Beatles. We're going to play something from the new Ruddles release. Some of you know that the Ruddles are kind of making fun of the Beatles, but you don't hear so much about the Ruddles anymore. New Ruddles release called Archaeology. We'll get into that next. Horse stealing was punishable by hanging in days gone by, but local residents should know. Horse thieves are still around in the 20th century. Mounted city policemen are having their horses stolen, sometimes right out from under them, by an organized ring that successfully grabbed 148 city-owned horses so far this year. Experts believe the horses will be trained to attack mankind and let loose in a dangerous herd, which should stampede and trample toward any human habitation and kill. However, don't worry. You can help. Send $1 to the Mr. Mark Horse Rescue Fund, and your money will help pay for the cost of this announcement. Positive thinking. What is it? And how does it work? Many experts believe that your personal state of mind affects your luck, your health, your physical well-being. These people have a positive thinking project for you. Here's an idea you can try in your own life. Tonight, unlock all your doors and windows and leave them that way all night long. Positive thinking will guarantee your safety when the burglars come. Pick up the phone and write for the facts about these and other brainwashing cults. Write to Box 7. Hey, kids, when people don't cooperate, then things go badly. Cooperation is good. When people don't cooperate, then giant monsters may as well come right down out of the sky and kill the president. Others say that when people do cooperate, you have to split the money more ways. But in truth, when people do cooperate, then pregnancy and childbirth rates go up, and we overpopulate our planet in ecological catastrophe. Please don't cooperate too much. Or if you must cooperate, just cooperate by yourself while you're sleeping in the bathtub. Okay, the music you are listening to is made possible by a grant from a strange, dark lady, and all I wanted to do was die in her arms. Plus, I got the money. Help support the station, and things like this could happen to you, too. Just call us up. The Mr. Mark Show comes to you straight through the air. Broadcasted, some say, from outer space. But just the opposite is true. We broadcast into space. Stay tuned for more music or whatever else I can find. The Mr. Mark Show. Valley residents, the extremely important Mr. Mark radio show starting up, which only goes to show you that it's Wednesday night. You just heard Greater Than One, the track Why Do Men Have Nipples? That's the actual title of that piece. In the background right now, Prodigy with Firestarter. Attention, you guys. Take assertiveness training. A course for achievers has been developed. It's a big secret hidden away from the prying eyes of consumer advocates, revealed only to you. In this special radio offer, you can become a success only if you make a lot of money. Assertiveness training is quick. It's easy. It's done with safe electrical stimulation to those pleasure centers in the brain. Pick up the phone and register. If you've been through the course already, register again and again. Just call us up. A word from your government. Your snake or other reptile can't stand cold. In a closed car in wintertime, with the windows rolled up, temperatures can plummet to 15 degrees in minutes. Don't leave your snake or other reptile in a cold automobile. Take it along inside with you, or at least leave your windows rolled all the way down. If you own a dog, cat, or bird, consider releasing your pet back into the wild. Animals have feelings too, and they don't like being cooped up. They don't like taking their meals out of a can. They want to hunt and kill the natural way. If it really loves you, it'll come back someday when it's hungry.
Well, there is this story about a Scotsman, an Englishman, and a Chinaman. They were in prison. In a prison. And of course, they were trying to escape. Now first, went the Englishman, then the Scotsman, and then the Chinaman. He jumped over the gate and said, I'm the ID, Bill and Spikey.